In the last video on taxing hamburgers, I did a somewhat artificial thing where I taxed hamburgers with an absolute dollar amount. Typically, consumption taxes are a percentage of the actual price of the good. So for example, sales taxes might be 8% or 9% of whatever you are buying. So let's think about how the supply curve, as perceived by the consumers, would look if we had a percentage tax. So now our government, instead of taxing $1 per hamburger, let's say that their tax is, and I'll make it big just to make it clear so that we can see the result of it. Let's say their tax is 20% of the price. 20% of the price of the hamburger. So let's think what's going to happen. Just like we saw in the last video, in order for producers to even think about producing that first hamburger, they need to get $2 per hamburger for it, because that's their opportunity cost. Using those same inputs, that same labor and resources, they could produce their other opportunity would give them at least $2. So you have to give them at least $2 in order to focus on hamburgers. And every incremental hamburger after that, the opportunity cost goes more, because now they'll be using things that are slightly less suited for making hamburgers and maybe slightly more suited for making other things. Now, that very first hamburger, you need to get $2 for it from the supplier point of view. But from the consumer point of view, they can't just pay $2 for it. They're going to have to pay $2 plus 20% of the $2. So 20% of $2 is 40 cents. So from the consumer's point of view, I'll do it in blue, they're going to have to pay about $2.40. And right over here, if you want to get the suppliers to produce about 2.5 million hamburgers per day, they're going to have to get, especially for those incremental hamburgers, in order to get the 2.5 millionth hamburger produced, you're going to have to give $3 per hamburger for the supplier. But the consumer is not going to be able to pay $3. They're going to have to pay $3 plus 20%. So that's $3.60. So that will put us right about there. And if you go further, instead of $4, so if you want the producers to produce right around 4 million hamburgers per day, you'd have to pay them $4. But the consumers would have to pay 20% more than that. So they're going to have to pay $4.80. And so what you're going to see is, from the consumer's point of view, the supply curve, is going to look something like this. It's not going to shift a fixed amount up. It's going to shift 20% up. So let me do that. So it's going to shift something like that. So for lower values, it's going to shift a less absolute amount, because 20% of $2 is less than 20% of $3, which is less than 20% of $4. So as we have more quantity and more price, it'll shift up more and more, because 20% will then become a larger absolute amount. So the shift would look something like this. But at any given point, that is 20%. That is 20%. 20%. It's 20% higher than the price that the suppliers, than the producers would see. So it's going to be 20% higher than, say, $6 there. So this is going to be $1.20 higher. But you have the same exact phenomenon that we saw in the previous video. In the previous video, this entire area was the surplus that both the consumers and the producers share. Now the equilibrium quantity is less. Now the equilibrium quantity is less. It's going to move right over there, because we have this new curve. So our new equilibrium quantity is over here. So neither the consumers, nor the government, nor the producers are going to be able to take advantage of this surplus, which was there when you didn't have the taxation. So this is why taxation is generally considered inefficient. Obviously, you have to do some of it, but it's generally inefficient. It reduces some level of economic activity, at least if you make all the assumptions in this model. And you have this deadweight loss, this surplus that can't be had by anyone. So there, you still have a deadweight loss. And if you look at the revenue that the government will now have, it'll still be this quantity. So it looks like our equilibrium quantity is now 3 million hamburgers per day, which is about what we got in the last one. And obviously, I'm not doing this very precisely. And it's going to be 60 cents. So 20% times $3 is 60 cents. So the height is going to be 60 cents. So this height right over here is 60 cents. And the width right over here is 3 million hamburgers. So it's going to be 60 cents per hamburger which is 20% of its price, per hamburger, times 3 million hamburgers. 3 million hamburgers gives us $1.8 million, per day. And just like the previous one, now the producer's surplus has shrunken. The producer's surplus is now just going to be this area right over here. The producer's surplus is just going to be that area right over there. And the consumer surplus has also been shrunken. It's been bitten into by the tax revenue. So the tax revenue and the deadweight loss takes from both the producer and the consumer surplus.